all the dignitaries on stage, all the Innerwheel members, Rotary members, all the guests who have come from Bangalore, family members. Really, really a warm welcome to you. And I know, we used to be Rotary Club members in 1999, and I know what an important ceremony this is. It was such a lovely ceremony. Just brought back such wonderful memories, and it's my honor that you have invited me as your guest today. And thank you, Shalini, for really wonderful words that you said. I'm wondering who you're talking about. So I'm just reminded of somebody I knew very well. She was in school, and you know her orthodox, protected environment. All she did in school was try to be first, second, third, fourth, fifth rank. And then, when she went to college, she attended a public speaking class. And the first time she spoke in front of an audience, she was so nervous, she started stammering, you know, But we all have our fears, isn't it? We are all nervous before we actually do something new. So at that time, you have a choice. You can just allow your fear to stop you and don't do anything, don't go on stage again. Or have the fear, acknowledge your fear, yes, I'm scared to go on stage, but continue practicing. So this college girl continued practicing on stage. And in her college, she got the third prize for one public speaking competition. And that third prize made a big difference to her confidence. And today, I said, do you know who I'm talking about? Who am I talking about? No? That person is standing in front of you. Today I teach people how to talk on stage. And when I go to school, people tell me, you, Shobha, specs, two plants? Yes, same Shobha. So the point I'm telling you is that whatever happened in your past does not matter. What matters is what happens in the present and what actions are you taking in the present. So it's been a big journey from that stammering person on stage to where I am today. And you know, in the middle of my law degree, I got married, I got a son, I completed my degree after that. And in my whole 20s, I was looking after two small children. And I was a full-time housewife and I was not happy about it. You know? So my 20s were a very angry young woman. So how many of you all have gone through the stage where you feel that I have great potential, I have not used it? Think about it. Some kind of unexpressed hidden anger, because you want to do something more in your life other than just be with your family. And we women, we, as much as we love our family, we are trying to balance everything together. So that is how my 20s went. And in my 30s, from an angry young woman in my 20s, I became a confused young woman in my 30s. You know, in 30s I was very confused because our parents' generation, they were so happy. My mother was happy being a housewife and a mother. My daughter was very clear she'd be a career woman. We are stuck in between. We don't want to be full-time housewives. We don't want to be full-time career woman. So 30s was a time of experimenting. So I tried different career options. I was very lucky to get a break in Bombay Times as a journalist for my writing. And my column was called Ordinary People. So I used to interview people on the road. You know, your fruit seller, vegetable seller. And interact with them and you realize that nobody is ordinary. Every single person has got something really extraordinary about them. You know, and that was so beautiful. I went on interviewing 150 people and I wrote a book about it. It's called From Ordinary to Extraordinary. That was my first book. And we were trying different, you know, see, when I want you to think, okay, the first time I got to understand there are a lot of entrepreneurs here in your group. But I want you to go back and think the first time you decided to start a job or start a business, you know, you have this fear within you. And one of the most common fear that we have is fear of failure. We are so scared to fail. We have fear of good impression. Oh, what will they think? I hope I make a good impression. And we have this fear of failure. Think about it. The fear that you have in your head is of two kinds. The real fear is like when you're standing in front of a train. You know, it lasts just 5 seconds. But most of the time, what is ruling our life is this imaginary fear. Imagine what happens. Suppose I fail, people will laugh at me, I want to start a business. So, I started once, my first experience of starting a business was when I was in my 30s, I started workshops, summer camps for children. You know, we don't want to take risks, so we take small steps we take. You know, so me, my two children, my friends, two children, at least four children will get in our camps, plus whoever joins. So that's how I started. My initial workshops was with school children. I joined Times NIE. I was lucky. I went to all the different schools of Bangalore, more than 400, 500 schools. I was a personal development consultant doing workshops for children across Bangalore. And so in 30s, we were trying to see what we can do. So I want to tell you one thing, you know, have your fear, take your action. Don't stop. Don't allow the fear to stop you, because most of your fear is an imaginary fear. So I kept taking action. And then what happened was, we are all wondering what to do, what to do. So because I was training students, I started attending training workshops. And before I realized it, one day I was 40. And in this training workshop, which I attended, I said, oh God, what can I do with my life? I've become 40. What have I done with my life? And when you do this training workshop, you spend time with the most important person in your life. Who's that? You all spend time with the most important person in your life. Who is that? You, yourself. So all the people who have started a business or a job or a career, you know, think that it is like getting into one bus. So what we do is that we get into the bus. Everybody stand up. Think we are going into the bus. Come on, everybody stand up. Stand up 1 minute. Stand up. So get into the bus. And then all day you're working. And then get down. Sit down, sit down. Then next morning you get up. Again, get into the bus. Stand up. Sit down. Stand up. Sit down. Stand up. Sit down. That's all we're doing. We do not know where our bus is going. You will ask me a question. If I say, come with me, you will say, where is the bus going? So at 40, I asked this question, where am I going? And in that workshop, I got insight. I said, I changed my thinking. And I said, it was, oh God, I'm 40. What have I done with my life? To, oh, I'm only 40. There is so much more I can do with my life. Trust me, this change of insight made a huge difference. And I was like a person in, you know, in 40s, I said, we all want to get into the rat race and we want to do more and more and more. And so all those who are working in the business, always look at how you can take your job or your business to the next level. You need to think and plan and do something different. When you go to sleep in the night, ask yourself, what new did I do today? So from teaching school children, I got a chance to go and teach MBA students. So Iqfa Business School was one of the first schools which had soft skills as a curriculum. So I'm very nervous for the interview, but I got the job. I'm very nervous when going and talking to over-smart MBA students, but they don't know I'm scared. So I went up on stage, I did that first class. I told you, have the fear, take the action. And I got one of the best ratings for teaching college students. So from school students, I went to college students. And then I went to Bombay and I worked in a training company. So by 40, you ask yourself, whatever business you're doing, ask yourself if it really makes you happy. You know, when we do workshops and people come back and tell us, man, you did, you know, it was so nice. We did this, you know, when you get the feedback from your customers, when you get smiles from your people that you're working with, it makes a huge difference. Okay, so ask what makes you truly happy. And I found my passion, I found my calling in 40s. And so from school children to college students to corporates, I worked for a training company. Don't look at the money. Money was not much. Just look at the experience, what you're learning. So much of amazing clients we had all across India. I would travel and I would do training. And we're running in this rat race. We want to become rich. We want to become famous. And one day I was 40. One day suddenly I was 50. You know, we want to become rich and famous, but we also become fat. Have you ever met somebody who is rich and famous and thin? Very rare. And in 30 years of marriage, I put on 30 kgs of weight. I said, oh God, what am I doing with my health? So 50s was the time we started focusing on my health. You know, suddenly, and now COVID has come, so everybody knows how important it is to focus on your health and your happiness. One of your thing I saw over there, you know, Sheroes. We all have the superwoman within us. And so we look at physical tips and mental tips. So after attending a lot of things, I started my training company. And this is called the Smile Makeup Theory. So I'll quickly go through what this theory is about. I want you to, you know, most of the time, we think about ourselves, we think about our strengths, and we also think about so many so-called weaknesses or areas of improvement. So I want you to go back to the time that you were just born. Imagine that you came out of your mother's womb and the doctor held you upside down, gave you one shot, and the doctor said, this one is shy, this one is angry, this one is smart. Did the doctor do that? Did the doctor give any kind of labels to you? Say yes or no? No. How did you come out? You were absolutely self-expressed. You smiled when you wanted to smile, you cried when you wanted to cry. And you were born in a certain ambience, a certain community, you got certain values. So there is one inner smile maker child which is still there within you. And then you have your values. And then you went to school, you came on stage like this, you were supposed to sing a song. And imagine you went and you stood in front of the audience, all these lights came in front of you, what happened to your song? You forgot. That five-year-old child made a decision that I do not know how to talk to groups. Who made that decision? Who made that belief? That five-year-old child. So something happened in your past when you were a child. Something happened to you when you were in college. Your friend went and said, come on, say hello to him. You went and said hello and you were insulted. All your friends laughed at you. So whenever you have these strong incidents which have strong emotions, you make some label. So things keep happening in your life and you keep making labels. This person is like this, that person is like this, this man is like this, this situation is like this, COVID is like this. And you also make labels about yourself. I am like this. My situation is like this. Now my question to you is, who made these labels? Who made all these labels and these beliefs? Who? You yourself. So who can take it out? Only you. You're not even aware that you have made this belief. Because every situation has got something positive about it, something not so positive about it. So you have a choice. You can keep crying about the negative part of it, or you can focus on the positive part of it. When you go home and look into the mirror, I want you to look eye to eye. Look at yourself in the mirror. All of you. You know who's your biggest critic in life? You yourself. But do you realize that you're a package deal? You got good points and your bad points. So look into the mirror, all of you all. Lift your right hand up. Everybody, lift your right hand up. Come on now. Lift your left hand up. Put your right hand on your left shoulder. Left hand on your right shoulder. Think that you're looking in the mirror and say, I love you. Come on, come on, I want to hear that. I can't hear. Loudly, loudly, I love you. I really love you. I really love you. Yeah. We talk about love, love, love all the time. But unless you love yourself, how can you give love to others? Yeah? So promise me you'll go back and do this thing. Okay? But that small child is still there within you. That small, happy, smiling child is still there. You've just forgotten how to take care of him or her. Okay? So every day, this is the smile maker self that you're going to enjoy. And from, I tell you, in my 50s, my life only became about contribution. What way we can contribute to the world. So cleanliness, I was like a maniac woman going behind everybody trying to clean the roadside garbage. From 2003 I've been doing that. You know? And they say, Dil se kuch in Kannada hetra. In Hindi they say, Dil se kuch mangoge to jannat bhi aapko dega. You ask something from your heart. Don't think how it's going to be done. But just believe in it. I used to go around everywhere talking about clean India, to undertake so much of projects, go on the road, middle of the night, and one day Swachh Bharat became a reality in 2014. So let me conclude with, that was my vision, which started in 2007, which became a reality. And now I have a vision to live in a world of smile makers. So anybody who finds a positive view of life and who is able to smile, find smiles anywhere, anytime, and make people around you smile, that person is a smile maker. So all of you all are my partners? Yes or no? Can you all be my smile maker partners? I really have this vision. Okay, COVID happened, my whole family got COVID, but you are still smiling. We use COVID as an example, as an excuse to stop smiling. I always said, I told my husband, eat all the kinds of healthy food, whatever you can. It was a detox time. It was a weight loss time for us. It was a time to do some painting. It was a time to do some writing. We made full use of, in my life I never sat at home for 1 month. And 1 month I was sitting at home. So there is a good part in every way. You have to have the ability to find smiles and make smiles. Okay? So I have this vision of living in a world of smile makers. So I do that with my training workshops. So one of the services that I'm giving, a lot of Moondugri members are coming. One of the services that I gave was, we You know, we give physical tips and mental fitness tips every Tuesday and Friday on our virtual workshops. And in your own small way, you know, your Rotaries, you have so many programs. I love that Sri Shakti, you know. Help the women entrepreneurs. You know, Karishma Kapoor tells you, come and buy one shampoo, lovely hair, nice shampoo, you'll go running and buy the shampoo. But if your friend is making homemade soaps and selling, you'll ask a question, side effect unda, aagbodha, eshtu, yaake. We ask 101 questions we ask. So please support the entrepreneurs who are there next to you. Anybody, whether you like it or not, I generally buy it. If I see somebody doing homemade, buy that. You know how happy he is. You know, and always do something extra. Think of the person that you went to the bank and how that man did some extra service to you. Whenever you give something extra, people will remember you for that. You know, when you go, people will not remember what you said or what you had or what you did. People will only remember how you made them feel. And how you can make them feel? Just make them smile. Make sense? Yeah? So I would request all of you all, the Sri Shakti program which is there, your health and happiness program that is there, Shiro, bring out the Shiro in you. You know? Bring out that old age. You know, what do you think old people want? They only want your time. They want you to sit and listen to them. You don't have to do anything. Just sit with them and listen to them. That's the biggest service you're doing in old age homes. Correct? Yeah? You know? So there are so many things, these Rotary projects which you are doing, your innovative projects that you are doing. Don't do it that, oh, this is a project, tick mark, tick mark, tick mark, I did this, I did this, I did this. Think that every project that you are doing, you know, we just now gave fees to a college student, an MBA student, where is he? Tomorrow he'll be sitting in his cabin, he's gone out? Yeah. He'll be sitting in his cabin and he'll be making decisions and you're creating smile in his face. Think about how much smiles you all are creating with your innovative projects. Okay? So, thank you very much. I'm very, very, very honored to be present today and all the work that you're doing. I really wish you all the best. And what you're doing is also creating smiles, being my partner. And, you know, I put all that in my shobhasmilemaker.com. I try to, but you know, the world is full of smiles. You just have to find it and you have to create it and make it. So thank you for being my smile maker. My pleasure to be here today. Thank you.